everyone. I'm Chiara Giorio. I'm an atmospheric chemistry lecturer in this department and I'm part of the Physical Chemistry Research Interest Group. As you may guess from my accent, I am Italian. I was born and I grew up in Vicenza, a lovely city in the northeast of Italy, and I went to university in Padova, a university that is almost as old as Cambridge. I studied chemistry for my undergrad, and then I took on a PhD in molecular sciences, both at the University of Padova. Chemistry was not a love at first sight for me, but I became very passionate about it when I started my thesis and I started to work in the world of atmospheric chemistry. After my studies, I moved to the University of Cambridge, here in this department where I was a postdoc for 4 years. Then I became a researcher at the Centre National de la Recherche Scientifique in France, before moving back to the University of Padova, where I was a tenure-track assistant professor for about 2.5 years, before moving back here at the University of Cambridge as a lecturer. My research interests are around two main topics. One is air quality and the other one is climate. Concerning air quality, I am particularly interested in studying aqueous phase reactivity of atmospheric aerosol, and how the presence of a water environment, like for example in a fog droplet or in an atmospheric particle at high relative humidity, these can change the toxicity of the aerosol particles. For example, in the aqueous phase, coordination chemistry can happen, so the metals that are present in the aerosol particles can change their solubility and therefore their way of interacting with lung fluid once the particles get inhaled. The other research interest that I have is on climate. In particular, I am looking at measuring organic compounds in ice cores from Antarctica. In particular, I look at compounds that are emitted by terrestrial plants. These compounds can get oxidized in the atmosphere before they get transported to Antarctica. So they can give an idea what was the concentration of the oxidants in the past atmosphere. This information is very important also for understanding how the atmosphere will react to future climate changes, and they will give an indication on how air quality may change because of a changing climate. My main motivation for doing research in academia is freedom. I think this is the only job in which every day you can really decide what you would like to do, set your own goals and work on what you think is really important. So if I have to give an advice to myself as a young student, I would say to be more self-confident and have more confidence in the future, because life is not a 100-meter sprint, it's a marathon, and you should seek for opportunities, but also be open to opportunities that may come to your way.